you're worried about the future of the internet? Yeah, are you worried about regulation, privacy, censorship? How about getting demonetized, deboosted, or even deplatformed altogether? Yep. Yeah, right? How about getting fooled by deepfakes? Does that freak you out? All of these problems stem from one root cause, the walled garden model. Each of these companies has a proprietary index and distribution network. So if I'm an Apple Music user and you're a Spotify user, I can't share a playlist with you. And this isn't right. The web was always intended to be decentralized. But today, it's a hub and spoke shape. And it's at these hubs, these central points of failure, that platforms control what we access. The solution is a fully decentralized specification for indexing and distribution. We call it Open Index Protocol. Think of it like a library. We use the blockchain like the card catalog. It stores metadata about the information. And we use distribution networks like IPFS and BitTorrent like the library shelves. It's where the information is kept. There are many projects actively using it or preparing to. This photo is from a summit we had to plan for future development. The business model is the secret sauce. It's how we combine incentive and decentralization that's motivating such awesome projects to choose Open Index Protocol. There are five ways to capture value in the system. As a publisher, influencer, platform, storage and distribution provider, and security provider. When we're looking at the network in 3D like this, we have the perspective to see that capturing value falls into two basic categories, subjective and objective. The application layer competes on subjective quality, so these are things like user experience, curation and discovery, and original content. And the protocol layer competes on objective efficiency, so these are things like index security, file storage, and transaction confirmation. And since incentives influence outcomes, we are about to see deepfakes and fake news follow in the footsteps of email spam. They can be filtered out and no longer annoy us, because it's not just easy to solve this problem with Open Index Protocol, it's profitable. But the key is that these aren't hierarchical layers. The system is fully decentralized and there are no central points of failure. We are on the precipice of a generational format shift, the kind that revolutionizes industries. Sheet music to recorded music, radio to physical media like records, tapes, and CDs. We are about to see some giant companies fall and the next legendary companies rise, because we are now completing the shift from physical distribution to digital distribution. It started 20 years ago with Napster. But it hasn't been completed yet, because until now, there hasn't been an open specification that was capable and flexible enough for everyone. When we began working on this 5 years ago, no one even believed that these problems were possible. But now, we have the technology ready to go mainstream right as the world is calling for it. The biggest concern with unintended consequences is that the technology will be used by criminals to distribute illegal content, and I do worry about how innocent people could be harmed, but I also remind myself that this same argument was used against the printing press and many other advancements in distribution technology. And to be totally honest, I wanted to work on this project because it creates a lot of cool, new, positive externalities. What sets Open Index Protocol apart is that it's fully decentralized, interoperable, permissionless, and open source. The founder of Overstock, Patrick Byrne, revealed on a shareholder call that they are building a bunch of technology on OIP and that they chose it because of how the business model combines incentive and decentralization. And we have been honored to be supported by the inventor of the World Wide Web himself, Sir Tim Berners-Lee, who has publicly called our technology thrilling. We work with people who believe in the freedom of the internet. Right now, we're looking for developers, we're educating government officials, and we're raising a seed round to launch our browser application. If you want to help make the internet free again, or you know someone we should speak with, I hope you'll reach out. Thank you.